They're here.
No, you need to tell.
Oh, hey. Hi, ladies.
Hey, will you take a seat for a minute? We need to talk to you, man.
Yeah, what's up?
Look, we're all here because we really care about you.
No one wants to see you go down this destructive path. We all want the best for you.
What do y'all mean? I'm fine.
Matt, you blew through the entire 2023 gun budget in January.
And our kids' college fund is gone.
First of all, those are investments. And secondly, let's be honest, those kids aren't really college material.
Dude, you don't even lift with me anymore. What about the gains?
I am gaining. An arsenal.
Look, Matt, this isn't a joke. You haven't seen your kids in weeks. Do you even remember their names?
Yes, I do. Matt Jr. and... How dare you?
That's what I thought. I thought you said David was coming.
I know, he said he'd be here.
Hey guys, sorry I'm late.
You didn't.
You didn't.
David!
David!
What the hell, man?
What the hell, man?
What's wrong with you?
I thought you said we were giving Matt an intervention.
You guys!
Oh my god!
Is this from Modern Warfare 2?
I thought y'all were going to talk first. That's what yeah, I think so. Hey, welcome to Demolition Ranch. I'm joined by Operator Drewski and Batty. And I actually just got this M200 intervention yesterday. We got it from Classic Firearms. Big supporters of the channel. Thank you, guys.
I wore my... Oh.
and I actually texted both these guys yesterday because I knew that they would be all over this thing. And I texted Drew. You were funny. I sent him a picture of the round first.
I said, cool, can I shoot it?
Yeah. this one's chambered in 408 Chi-Tac. And then I texted Batty just the round, and he was like, such a good round. And then I texted him a picture of the gun, and he said, an expletive.
Yeah, I said a lot of...
It was like a loving, screw you, is basically what he said.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then, last night, I texted both of them again, and I said, do y'all want to come shoot it tomorrow? And then I went and checked Batty's Twitch, because I figured he's probably on there. And it's a little delayed. What, probably 5 seconds delayed?
About five, yeah.
And so I texted him, and I got on his Twitch, and he goes, hold on, guys. And he gets his phone out on live stream. He goes, hold on, guys. And he goes, and he runs away. And he leaves the stream. Like, there's just an empty room, and Batty's gone for, like, 5 minutes. And then he comes back, and he's like, sorry, guys, got a cool text. I had to do something tomorrow, so I had to go check if I could do it or not. It was
I had plans. I had to move stuff around. This is important.
So
this is Marky Marks.
This is Marky Mark in Shooter. This is what he had. An M200 intervention chambered in 408. What's this chamber? We don't know what it was chambered in. Did they say?
Sure they called it a 50 or something.
They probably called it a 50
at some point.
They have these in 375 Chi-Tac and 408 Chi-Tac. Is that all they were chambered in? Actually, I'm not. I don't know. What are they chambered in the video games?
408.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We got the big boy. So what's interesting about the 408 caliber, actually I'll show you when we have a round. We're down range right now. I'll show you more about the round in a second, but I'll show you what we're shooting at right now. This. Ugh. Y'all picked this up yet?
Oh. Yeah.
That is a solid block of bronze. We actually had this thing specially made because we've been shooting different kinds of metals to see what happens. So we decided to get like a really hard metal today to see what some big boy sniper rounds can do to a solid block of bronze.
Probably a lot.
We're gonna stand behind like cover.
No.
Yeah, ballistic glass, right?
Like I'm gonna stand behind Matt.
No, we're gonna shoot it from right here. Our legs are gonna be behind the bulletproof glass.
Good.
Yeah, that's what's important.
Everything here down, totally
good.
Safe.
Good.
Everything here up, I think you'd probably be fine.
You've had kids, we haven't yet, so you can stand outside the glass.
Why
do you
say yet?
Whoa, look at that round. That actually is a .338 Lapua Magnum, which is a really big round.
That's big, right?
It's a sniper round, made to go fast and hard, just like Batty.
And
fast?
That's a weird looking airsoft BB.
Yeah. This is a 375 Shytac round. Obviously bigger and more powerful. More,
that seems a little too big.
That's a
too
bigger big. Airsoft BB.
More energy. This is the 408 Shytac. So you can just see it's a wider cross section.
Pointy.
A lot. Yeah, it's so sharp.
It's very sharp.
Knife.
Just a lot of energy there. So that's, you can see, just to get this one out. 330 Lapua Magnum is a huge round. Everybody talks about how powerful they are downrange. 408's a lot more. This is a 50 BMG for comparison. What are y'all doing? So what's actually really interesting about a 408 Shytac is past 400 yards, it has more energy than a 50 BMG. Under 400, this thing obviously is gonna have a lot more energy, but it has a lot more drag, so it slows down a lot in the air, whereas this one keeps its energy going.
That's science ballistics versus World War II. Give me a big mm-hmm. round that can go through things ballistics.
Yeah, so this one is made to shoot through engine blocks, to go through armor. This one is made to go really far and deliver a lot of energy really far away. So this one stays supersonic up to 2,200 yards. It's faster than the speed of sound, up to 2,200 yards, which is pretty crazy. Insane. Which is why if you're shooting something at 600 yards, this thing is gonna hit harder than this thing will. Science. So we are gonna shoot it at 100 yards. M200 intervention. Collapsible stock.
For the nose scoping.
Or for close quarters, breaching rooms, stuff like
that. Oh, you can't even get your, you can kind of get your hand around it. Bust the door down, I'll go in.
Yo, breaching, boom.
Boom!
That's how snipers do it. I was trained in that.
Yeah. Got him. Yeah, baddie, army sniper over here. That's why he got invited. Not because I like him, just because.
I'm okay with that. I will take that today.
This thing does have a lot of interesting features. The most notable that when you look at it is the carry handle that's on the bottom. That's pretty different from a lot of guns. Like Barrett's got one right here on the top. So it doesn't block your field of view. It's center of the gun. So you carry the gun upside down if you need a one-hand carry it. It's got a cool bipod that kind of goes over and around that barrel shroud. Also, this is threaded, so we need to get a suppressor for it.
You're not going to show that on the channel, though, when you put it on, right?
Definitely will not show screwing a suppressor, not that we screw it on. However, a suppressor attaches. However it attaches, I don't want to show anybody.
The comments on the video were like, thank you for keeping us safe so that we didn't know how to put a suppressor on a gun.
So when a mommy and a daddy barrel get together, sometimes a suppressor appears.
Yep. Also, you should go check out cfcontest.com. They have lots of epic giveaways. I highly suggest going to check it out. It's linked in the description as well. All right, you guys all want to see this thing fire, as do I. We have not fired a round because actually it's really hard to find 408 Shytac rounds. We only have a few of them right now. So we're going to start small. You guys know how this channel works. We'll start small, 760 by 39 out of the POF. We're going to hit that bronze block and see what that does.
We're gonna try to hit.
My guns are
kind of zeroed.
Sighted in, schmited in, you know, whatever. First up, 762 by 39. We got some regular rounds, we have two to see if we can hit it. And then I've got some steel core Chinese rounds to see what that does to the solid block of bronze. Bad, you wanna do it?
Oh man, I knew this was gonna happen.
Not sighted
at least
it's
not
all.
Giving me a pistol.
If you miss, we're gonna be like, Batty, what the heck, man? Come on. Are you smelling it? Don't smell it.
I'm ready, bro.
Oh, it's a solid hit. Perfect. Right in the middle. Dude. Oh my gosh.
Sniper.
That was right in the. There's no way. There's no way.
All
right,
dude, this is another regular round.
Miss.
All right, these are steel core.
That's
it. Let's call it right there.
Woo!
It's good.
Dude,
clear the gun.
Shot.
Let's go check it out. That's not going to happen again. We're going to be shooting all over the place. Look at the
hole. It's falling.
So we have it at a slight angle because of that. Shooting a metal is scary.
Oh, man. It's right dug
me
out.
And we're at 100 yards.
But this was your first shot. This is your second with the steel core. There is a little bit
more of a hole there, but not much. It didn't do a whole lot. So now we're going to move it up to a 7.62 by 54 R. R stands for retarded fast. Next up, the Romanian beauty, the Romanian Dragunov clone. We are shooting some 7.62 by 54 R, but we got some some trick bullets as well, some spicy boys. These are from Denver Bullets. We pretty much most of our weird bullets today are from Denver Bullets. This is an API round. I have never shot an API out of this thing. So we're gonna shoot a couple rounds first, see how it goes, and then we'll fire the API round. And Drewski's doing the honors.
Good luck, Drew.
I don't wanna end up like Kentucky.
Ugly?
No.
Here you go.
It's a PSL, you filthy casual.
The PSO scope in this is yellow and foggy as an airsoft NC Star scope from like 2011. So it's gonna be a good time.
You hit too far left.
Okay.
You hit about 5 inches left. Yep, that's a solid hit. That's great.
Got it.
Do that again, bring it down a couple inches. So this is our API round now. That was a miss.
Miss?
Damn. I don't know where that one went. I couldn't tell. Oh, there's smoke coming out of the wood.
Really?
Yep.
Well, that's scary.
That's cool. Oh, man, yeah. That shooting...
Dude, that's smoking.
2 feet left and a foot up. I think we screwed up a firing pin on this gun. Yeah, we'll go check out what the regular Full Metal Jacket did, and we're done with this gun. Should have bought a real Russian Dragunov.
You hit it here?
Oh, I thought I only hit it on the side.
No, you hit it here, and I said...
Okay, cool.
I said hold an inch off, and you held here, so it's still the exact same.
That's FMJ?
Yeah, that's regular FMJ. So Dang. That is a bigger hole than our 7.62s. So that was his first shot. I told him to hold here. He did hit right there. And then those APIs went everywhere. We couldn't figure that. Oh my gosh.
Tried my best.
What? That's it.
Whoa.
That's why we are 100 yards back. Because it's throwing stuff back like
went
that.
Went into the 2x4.
Yeah. That's nuts. Let's shoot something bigger and probably more accurate. Look at all this splatter here. We kind of noticed this thing's not really moving a whole lot. So we're going to mark where it is.
Good idea.
And we're gonna shoot it with 3 in a wind mag now and see how much off that mark it is. I think we'll shoot at the same surface right now. We'll see what it does. 3 in a wind mag out of the Petra. We also have our last shot is a API. A little silver tip. We're gonna fire 2 regular ones to see where it's going first. Drew wants to redeem himself, but it really wasn't Drew. It was that gun. Something's going on with it.
Yeah, Drew broke the gun. That was what was going on with it.
That's what's going on is Drew messed up everything.
Steals your guns, breaks your guns.
That hit the block, but it hit on the left slant.
Got it.
And you're about an inch low and about 4 inches to the left. I'd say aim right side. Yep, perfect hit.
Cool. Next round is the API.
Yeah. Oh, that was
Whoa, it's blasted. It's black.
That was cool.
Nice.
Special rounds.
Guns empty.
Hey, dude, that one worked great, Drew.
That has smoke all over it.
Covered it black.
Bang. Jumped right out in front of you, did it?
Dude, look at this one you skimmed off the side. It ripped the table up. That's crazy.
Whoa.
Okay, so his first one's here. I told him pull it right. He did. That is his next shot with a 3 in a wind mag. And then this is his API round.
We stacked that a little bit with
looks like the bullet. And you can see where it went. But look at our line, how much it knocked it off being hit with those 3 rounds. And it is tearing this up. All this wood came off. That's new because it just went firing all this way. 3 in a wind mag, even API, is not actually doing very much damage to this bronze block at all. Fortunately, we're gonna have to shoot it with a 4-way Shytac. We should spin it, we should get a fresh side this time. Before we shoot the bronze block though, I think we should just shoot the Shytac a little bit, see what she does.
No one here has ever fired M200 intervention, right?
Nope.
Much less this one. It's a learning experience.
Ah!
Okay, so the guys at Classic Firearms did actually fire it. So we know it works. They said this magazine is a little loose. So they said sometimes, like last round, it sometimes can like knock out like that. But we'll see what happens. We're gonna shoot on paper first. Kind of try to figure out where it's going. All right, y'all ready?
Yep.
I'm just gonna aim center mass.
Put one on the bottom left circle.
Bottom left.
I thought he wasn't gonna bolt it. I thought he wasn't gonna bolt it.
Oh, that sounded so good.
Cool thing about this, it's like $15 a shot. So we just spent $30 and we're not sure where those bullets went. But look at this.
I see that top one first.
So just bore sighting this thing and comparing it to where the scope is, yeah, it's like 3 feet off, like 3 feet high. So like when I'm aiming at that white target we were hitting, the board's probably 3 feet above it. So we didn't want to just keep firing because it's getting expensive very quick. So we're gonna adjust our scope and see if we can put it on paper. They fired this thing, but we're not sure how much they fired it or if they really sighted it in. But yep, it's off.
We're cranking, trying to just get a
bore sight action.
Close bore sight, because right now it is not. I was thinking while we're sitting here, we just put a 1X on top, just a little red dot, and we could SBR this thing. Whew, that'd be sick.
The 1X was my idea. Actually, I was saying we should just pop an ACOG on. It'll be zeroed automatically.
Automatically. But close. Think about this thing, but with like an 8-inch barrel. Oh, the fireball. I'd love it.
How's she looking? Getting there?
I think we're good enough. That's what I think.
Good enough. That's what I like to hear. And an ultra precision rifle, we just need good enough.
It's a bore sight. That's all bore sight is.
Let's try it again. I got another 15 bucks, so why not, you know? I'm just going to aim center mass. I see a hit.
We're
on
high.
Paper.
We're snipers, right?
We're snipers now. We did it.
Bring it down 7 inches.
Okay.
Or honestly, Matt.
And left.
Yeah.
Say less. Bullseye. We did it.
I mean, that's a pretty good foresight. Two shots. We're in. All right. Giddy up, partners. Batty's going to take his first shot. Batty.
Yeah.
Don't fall in love.
I mean, I'm going to.
Were you aiming bottom left?
No.
Oh, that's way off.
That's great.
Yeah, you're 5 inches, 4 inches left and 3 inches low.
Sweet.
How'd it feel though?
That feels great. That trigger is phenomenal.
There's nothing there.
Yeah. Just barely touch that trigger. It's in center ring. You're about an inch and a quarter low. That'll hit that block on left.
Oh yeah.
That is a sharp, yeah. It's very little kick actually.
Very little.
But it's very sharp, very
it's
quick.
The gun's so heavy.
Yeah. Like, yeah.
It's as heavy as a Barrett. Whew. It really is not bad at all. And it feels good.
It sounds that.
That is
that's
nuts.
That's the best part.
We are sighted in. Now I kind of want to see, we have a half inch steel AR-500 target down there, which will stop 50 BMG all day. I want to hit it with a 408 and see what it does. You bringing it right in?
I nice. Cannot. Nice. We're that close. You gotta.
We should be pretty dead on now. Let's, who wants, you want to shoot steel?
Yeah, do let it. Batty do it. Let Batty do it.
Batty's going to slap that half inch AR-500 man in the face. And we're going to see what a 408 Shytec does to steel that will stop a 50 BMG. But this is going way faster.
You good to go?
Yep. Dude.
I think it. I think it took it fine. We'll go down there and look.
Not even a dent.
No hit marker.
No hit marker popped up.
That's literally a hit marker. That's what they hit.
See a little thing.
So that's solid copper bullets. So it left a little copper on the target, but no dent.
Thing is crazy.
So good.
I feel just like Bob Lee Swagger. What?
Huh.
The Earth's round, right?
Yes.
No.
There's only one way to know.
How long is it gonna take?
Earth is like 200 miles wide.
Firing a 408 Shytac out of an M200 intervention
at a solid bronze block. Dude, it flipped it around.
Hit it so hard.
And it shot it off to the right. You can see it hit the dirt mound to the right. That's a hit!
Oh my god.
Dude, it still barely did anything!
But it moved it.
So it was right there. You can see where our line was, and it was all the way back here, spun around. But I mean,
look at the chunk it blew out of there.
It was a lot. And so this would make a little bit deeper if we had it flat, but we're trying to be safe because I don't know if y'all could see, but it hit that and threw dirt everywhere. So there's still a lot of energy coming back, which we don't want coming back at us.
Do you shoot it with a 50 BMG now?
Yes.
It's a tradition here.
I guess we'll do it. I don't want to do it.
What a shame.
Barrett M82. We got some regular full metal jacket and then a black tip. So we'll see what happens.
Never loaded a Barrett before.
It rocks in.
Oh, it rocks in. Yep. Like an AK.
There you go.
Yep, got it.
Don't like that. You just sound like an AK.
Ooh. Barrett's just like an AK, basically. Stop. It's like a big AK is all it is.
Okay. I'm going to hit the two at the bottom.
Gotcha.
Try to hit in between them.
So
I went way off, didn't I?
That's like a foot high.
I went up right, correct?
All right, we're try again.
Shooting between the two.
Yep. Even higher.
I feel like I was more on that shot.
Let me try one shot.
Yep, go ahead. Safety's on.
I'm going to aim at those two copper ones at the bottom. I'm going to aim at the lower one.
Yep, gotcha. You hit exactly where Drew did his first shot. Like in the hole.
So it's way off.
Yeah.
The gun's off, Drew. It's not
Hey,
you.
Hey, I'm a good sniper.
Okay, well, your second shot was even off for being off.
We're going to confirm that this thing is way off. I'm going to try to hit that lowest copper. Yep. Way too far left.
You know, I just got so used to the Shytac being like accurate. This Barrett's just way off.
All right, we're going to try wing it.
This is a black tip going at the block.
Nice.
It spun it.
Flipped it. I can see it. Good hit, man.
I was aiming like 9 feet above it and like 4 feet right. Nailed it.
Hey, Matt. Huh. Honorary sniper.
Oh my god. I've been waiting my whole day for this.
Whole day. Yeah, it's been all day.
It knocked it over. I didn't even realize that. It pushed it backwards.
What do you mean?
Oh, it flipped it. It flipped it. This was on top.
Holy.
Hey, Matt.
Dang. That would. There's more right there, too.
Oh, that's it?
That. Don't touch that.
Oh, cow. Yep. Hot. There's more right there.
Dang.
This is what you so don't much. Want coming back at you. Look at that. Oh, you can't see the bottom. That's a deep hole, dude. That's a good deep hole.
Sharp, too. Dangerous. Don't put your...
Oh,
golly.
I think I can see... Oh, that's weird. I mean, it's like the perfect shape of the bullet.
So I bet you that was all jacket that we pulled out of there. So I bet you that center core went it's deep just, and all the jacket like, flew back.
It looks like if you put a bullet in it, it would perfectly sit, like perfect seal. That's how the shape is in there. It's weird.
Plug that hole with a bullet.
Big thanks to Classic Firearms. Don't forget to go to cfcontest.com. It's worth a look, I promise you. Also, I also promise you that I'm going to someday shoot this thing at further than 100 yards. Maybe like 125, 150.
I thought you said you were gonna shoot this thing, and I was like shoot it.
Will an M200 intervention stop a 50 cal?
Thanks, Operator Drewski. No, thanks to Batty for being here. I love you, and I'll see you next time.
Shoot it.
Thanks for inviting me out, man. That was cool.
Yeah, super fun. Anytime. And if you guys don't mind, like, spot me like $300 for all the ammo you'll shot, that'd be awesome. $300 each.